I am a ghost. Ha 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 ha.
I am not a ghost, but the question is, do ghosts really exist? The stories about ghosts that we hear, are they really true? What does the Bible say? Hello friends, and you are welcome to Truth That Set Free. In the year 1990, a Hollywood movie was released entitled The Ghost. Now in this movie, a young man who was madly in love with a young lady was brutally murdered by a friend and a corrupt business partner over a shady business deal. But when he died, his spirit was left to roam in the world as a powerless spirit. But later, this spirit went to seek the help of a psychic and was able to communicate with his living girlfriend, and finally was able to kill the friend who murdered him. The question is, do dead people continue to roam the earth as ghosts as we know, as we have heard in stories and we have seen in Hollywood movies like The Ghost? You see, dear friends, there are a lot of stories of people claiming to have seen or have been visited by the ghosts of departed friends or family members. There are hundreds of movies about ghosts that have caused many people to believe that indeed ghosts really exist and they can harm or help the living. But what does the Bible say? Well, according to Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, the Bible makes us understand that God used two basic ingredients in the creation of mankind, that is dust from the ground and the breath from God. Again, the Bible makes us understand that death is the reverse of the creation of man. That is, when a person dies, the dust returns to the earth and the spirit goes back to God. Now in the Bible, when a person dies, there is nothing like the person roaming in the world after death. Only God has immortality. No human being has immortality. When a person dies, the spirit goes back to God and the dust returns to the ground where it came from. Remember that according to Genesis chapter 2 verse 7, it is only when these two elements are combined that we have a living soul, that is a living person. And so when a person dies and these two elements are separated, the breath alone is not a human being and the dust alone is not a human being. In Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 7, the Bible makes this very clear. It says that then the dust will return to the earth as it was, and the spirit will return to God that gave it. Dead people, my dear friend, have no memory of anything, and so they can never come back to the world to either help or harm the living. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 5, the Bible says, "For the living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing. They have no more reward." Again, Ecclesiastes chapter 9 verse 6, the Bible continues to say, "And their love, their hatred, and their envy have now perished." My dear friend, you do not need to be afraid of ghosts. No dead person can come back as a ghost according to the Bible. They have no knowledge of anything. That is why the Bible says that the dead do not praise God in Psalm 115 verse 17. Now, if that is the case, then the question is, where are the dead now? Well, my friend, the Bible says that all the dead are sleeping in their graves, waiting for the final trumpet of God to sound. In John chapter 5, reading from verses 28 to 29, our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming in which all who are in the graves will hear his voice and come forth, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of condemnation." Again, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verses 16 and then verse 17 says this, "For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we who are alive and remain shall be changed, and we shall be caught up to meet the Lord in the skies, and so we shall be with the Lord forever." So my dear friend, the simple truth that set free is that you do not need to be afraid of ghosts, because they are nothing but the spirit of demons impersonating the dead to work miracles, according to Revelation chapter 16 verse 14. You see, Satanists, believe in the immortality of the soul, but the Bible teaches that only God is immortal and that all the dead are sleeping in their graves. The next time that you see a ghost, rebuke that spirit by the name of Jesus Christ, and its true identity would be revealed. The Bible says, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." Shalom.